Welcome students on online class for the subject physics. Today we have learned about physics practicals. So today we have seen experiment number 2. That experiment will be sonometer law of length. This is the first law of sonometer. So for this experiment, first of all we have seen aim. The aim of experiment is to study the relation between frequency and vibrating length. Of given wire under the constant tension using sonometer. So for this experiment, apparatus is given. Apparatus for the experiment will be sonometer, slotted weights, with hanger, set of tuning fork, rubber pad, light, paper rider, meter scale. These are the apparatus which are used in the experiment. So in this experiment, theory or law of length, it will be the frequency of stationary transverse wave transverse vibration of a stretched string is inversely proportional to the vibrating length of the string if or when tension in the string and mass per unit length of string remains constant. Therefore, fundamental frequency or frequency of stationary transverse vibration n is inversely proportional to vibrating length of the string L. If tension T and mass per unit length of wire is kept constant. This is the theory for law of length, or this is the law of length given from theory. So a formula is there. Formula for a fundamental frequency of wire or frequency of vibration of wire, n is equal to 1 upon 2L square root of T upon M, where n is frequency of vibration of string, L is vibrating length, T is tension, and M is mass per unit tension, mass per unit length. So this formula is used for the sonometer law of length experiment. So we have seen the experimental formula. Let us see the experimental diagram for sonometer. First law, law of length. See here, two knife edges, K is there, length L is vibrating length, tuning fork T dash is given, applied mass tension is given, which is equal to mg, and P for pulley is given. Let us see. We have seen a set of tuning fork. The first tuning fork having value 256 hertz, next 288, next 320, another will be 341, next 384, next 426, next 480, and lastly the first tuning fork is the frequency for oval saw, next ray, next ga, ma, pa, dha, ni, sa, means the first tuning fork and last tuning fork, their difference will be, or their ratio will be 2. That we say that first tuning fork is octave the last, means first tuning fork having frequency 256 and last tuning fork having frequency 512. See here, again we have seen the construction for sonometer box. This is a sonometer box. This box, it contains two knife edges. This will be a knife edge. And here, when the reading for knife edge, we can read it here. Between two knife edge, a paper rider is there. Then this consists of a uniform wire which is fixed at one end. This wire passes over pulley, and another, this is a pulley, and so that this wire is connected to a mass. These masses like this. The masses are Each mass will shows 500 grams. So here this 500 grams mass will be 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Means we can see applied mass is 4000 gram. Applied mass is written as 4000 gram. Yeah, the 4. So mg is equal to 4000 multiplied by 980. It leaves 4000 multiplied by 980.
Stop.
So that tension will be 392000, means 3.92 into 10 to the power 6 dyne. Okay. A tuning fork having frequency 256 hertz is strike on rubber pad kept on the top of box so that paper rider suffers. Again, okay, see, note the reading will be, and here reading will be 50.5, and here 10 is there, another knife edge will be on 10. So difference between, for frequency 256 hertz, vibrating length will be 50.5 minus 10, that is 40.5.
Yes, sir.
Again, if we perform the second reading, then paper rider suffers, and take the reading for knife edge, that reading will be 51. Write down in L2, that is 51. For 256 hertz vibrating length, for second reading it will be 41 centimeter. The second tuning fork has value 288 hertz. If we strike on rubber pad and kept on sonometer box, so it shows paper rider suffers, and so it shows a reading that will be 47. For 288, 47 for frequency 288, vibrating length is 47 minus 10 is 37. Again, we take another reading. For this, it takes reading for 47. And another knife edge will be 10. So reading will be 30. Tuning fork that has the value 320 hertz. See here, 320 hertz. Strike on rubber pad and kept on top of box, so paper rider suffers, and give the reading for this, that will be 42, and here 10 is there, so 42 minus 10, it will be 32. So first we can write 320, here 32, vibrating length will be 32. Secondly, again When we strike, so that it also shows 42.2. So difference between 42.2, it will be 32.2. Next tuning fork, that is 341 hertz. So if we strike 341 on rubber pad and kept on the box, so paper rider suffers, and so it shows a reading for 36.5. so here 26.5, because 10 will be remaining, subtracting. Again, if we can strike on rubber pad, so that paper rider suffers, and it shows a reading for 37. So by subtracting 10, it is 27. Second reading will be 27. And lastly, if we take the fifth tuning fork, which has value 426 hertz, strike on rubber pad, kept on box, so paper rider suffers, and paper rider gives a reading for 31.5. 426, 31.5 minus 10, that is 21.5. And if we take second reading, paper rider suffers, again try, so it shows 31. So second reading will be 31 minus 10, that is 21.0. By performing the experiment, so first of all, we can calculate by the two length L1 and L2, mean length can be calculated. So the part of calculation is calculation. So first of all, length L is equal to L1 plus L2 upon 2. So first L is 40.5 plus 41 upon 2 will be 81.5 upon 2. So first length, it will be 40.75. So the length of frequency for 256, it will be 40.75. that is the length given. Here another length will be L1 plus L2 upon 2, it will be 37.0 plus 37.0 upon 2, that is 74 upon 2, it will be 37. So mean length for 288 frequency hertz, it will be 37.00. again, if we can find out length, third length, it will be L1 plus L2 upon 2, it is 32.0 plus 32.2 upon 2, it will be 64.2 upon 2, it is 31.1. so the length for frequency 320 hertz, it will be 31.1. again, if the fourth length is L is equal to L1 plus L2 upon 2, it is 26.5 plus 27 upon 2. So their addition will be 53.5 upon 2, and division will be 2 to the 4, 1 is remaining, 13 will be there, 2 6 the 12, 1 is remaining, 15 is there, point. So 2 7 the 14, 1 is there, and 2 5 the 10. So the mean length for frequency 341, it will be 26.75. And lastly, we have seen the length, it will be L1 plus L2 upon 2. It is 21.5 plus 21.0 upon 2. Its addition will be 42.5 upon 2. And its division will be 21.25. So the length for frequency 426, it will be 21.25 centimeter. Again, we want to calculate NL for NL. So the first question will be frequency N, it is 256 into L will be 40.75 by using logarithm. So if we use logarithm, the characteristics for 256 will be 2 point and characteristics for 40 will be 1 point, and their addition is there. So 25 in 6, its log will be 4082, and 40 in 7, 5 is mean difference, its log will be 6101. So addition is 38104. If we take its antilog, antilog of 0.1 in 8, 3 is mean difference, it will be 1.043 into 10 to the power 4. So NL for first reading, it will be 10,430. So we can substitute the value of NL in frequency 250, that is 10,430. That is the calculation for first reading. Again, if we can calculate for second NL, that is 288 multiplied by 37. So characteristics for 288, it will be 2 point, and characteristics for 37 will be 1 point. So their addition is there. So the log of 28 in 8 will be 4594, and log of 37 will be 5682. If we can add, it is 6, 17, 12 and 10, 1 is, so add, it will be 4 point. If we can take antilog of 0.02 in 7, 6 is mean difference, its antilog will be 1.065 into 10 to the power 4, and therefore NL for 288 Hz and 37 length will be 10,650. So if we substitute the value in observation table, that is 10,650 for second reading. So for the third reading, we can calculate here 320 multiplied by 31.1. So characteristics for 320, it will be 2 point, and characteristics for 31, it will be 1 point. So if add, if we can see in log, the 32, log of 32 will be 5051. Log of 31 in 1 will be 4928. If we add 819, 527, 909, 459, 0.123. Take the antilog of 0.99 in 7, 9 is in mean difference. It will be 9.951 into 10 to the power 3. So the answer for NL, it will be 9951. So if we can write in observation table the value for NL of 320 hertz, length will be 31.1, it will be 9951. Again, if we calculate 341 into 26.75, here the fourth calculation will be 341 multiplied by 26.75. The characteristics will be 2.1 point, and the addition will be here log of 34 in 1, it is 5328, and log of 26 in 7, 5 is in mean difference, will be 4273. So addition will be 11, 10, 6, 9, 3 point. If we can take antilog, so antilog of 0.96 in 0, 1 is mean difference, it will be 9.122 into 10 to the power 3, and their multiplication of 341 hertz and length 26.75, NL, it will be 9122. If we substitute the value in observation table, that is 9122. Again, we can calculate the next reading, that is 426 multiplied by 21.25. So 2 is the characteristics, 1 is the characteristics for 21.25. So if we can see the log of 42 in 6, so log of 42 in 6 becomes 6294, means 6294, and 21 in 2, 5 is mean difference, its log will be 3273. Addition 437, 97, 16, 22, 4 and 1, 5, and here 639, and addition is 12, that is 3. So if we can see antilog of 0.95 in 6, 7 is in mean difference, it will be 9.072 into 10 to the power 3. So here NL, frequency 426 multiplied by 21.25, NL is 9072. If we substitute the value in observation table, 9072, by adding all NL, we can calculate mean NL. So mean NL is calculated. So mean NL is mean NL. So we can add. So first of all, 10,430, 10,650, 9,951, 9,122, and 9,772. Their addition will be 221, it is 5, 7, 2, 9, 19, 20, 21, 22. 2 is remaining, 12 and 10, 22, 2 is remaining, 9, 9, 9, 27 and 2, 29, 2 is remaining, and here 49. So mean NL is equal to 49,225 divided by 5. So therefore mean NL is equal to 5 and the 5, 5, 9, the 45. Remaining will be 4, becomes 42, 5, 8, the 40, 2 is remaining, becomes 22, 5, 4, the 20, 2 is remaining, becomes 25, and 5, 5, the 25. So mean NL is 9845. So therefore mean NL, it will be 9845. We write result of experiment. The result of experiment is NL is equal to 9845 hertz centimeter, so which is constant. If NL is constant, then we can say that fundamental frequency or frequency of vibration of string is inversely proportional to the length of string. Hence, law of length is verified. When tension in the string and mass per unit length of string is kept constant, again we write the precautions. So for precautions, here number one, keep paper rider in middle. In middle of knife edges. Again, second precautions will be strike the tuning fork gently on rubber pad. Third precautions will be measure the distance between two knife edges accurately. These are the precautions for law of length. Again, if a question is asked for oral examination, the question will be state law of length. So this question has answer will be law of length state that frequency of vibrating string is inversely proportional to the length of vibrating string. If tension in the string and mass per unit length in the string is kept constant, the first question when asked state the law of length, then you get answer. Again, the second question will be what is fundamental mode of vibration? What is fundamental mode of vibration? If P number of loops are formed, then fundamental frequency is n is equal to P upon 2L square root of T upon M. So when P equal to kept as 1, means only one loop is formed between two knife edges, then P equal to 1. So N is equal to 1 upon 2L square root of T upon M. This frequency is lowest frequency, called as fundamental frequency, and the mode for vibration is called fundamental mode of vibration. Again, a question will be asked. Suppose the question is asked like, what is mean by free vibration? See here, it's asked, what is resonance? Then we can see resonance is the special case of forced vibration. Means if body is up vibrate, by an external periodic force, with a frequency of body, then body begins vibrate called resonance. See here, a hollow wooden box is used in musical instrument. In musical instrument, a hollow box is used because inside the box air is vibrate with same frequency, so sound is heard. And lastly, if a question is asked, that question will be why holes are kept on one side of sonometer. Sonometer box. So, sonometer box, when external periodic force is used, then in sonometer box holes, air inside the box. Actually, sonometer box is made up of wooden box, so air inside the box is vibrate with same frequency for string. When external periodic force is, then string vibrates and paper rider suffers. Finally, fault. This is the answer for why holes are kept on one side of sonometer box.